Hello there. It's time for my weekly Christian video. Now, last week I talked about sin, and that proved to be a little too controversial, I think. For one thing, I really focused on the idea of being sinners and not being ashamed of being able to say that word. Well, I think I got some objections to that, and Johnny, who is another BookTuber here, he told me that I should also focus on the fact that we're not just sinners, we're saints. So I thought that was very helpful. Anyhow, thank you so much for the comments. Those of you who left comments, they're very precious to me. And moving right along, I thought I'd just talk about what I'm reading right now, because after all, I'm a BookTuber, I am not a preacher. Sometimes I do rant, like I did have that little rant about sin in me. So, oh my goodness, let's just move on to love. It's a safe topic, right? At least I hope so. So I'm on the topic of love because I am reading in the Bible, 1 John, awesome book. So I've taken up the study of John, well, I did the Gospel of John, but now I'm in 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John, and absolutely loving it. And it's been a long time since I read 2nd and 3rd John, so that was nice for a review. So at the beginning of this copy of 1st John, this is the Life Application Bible in the New King James Version, and it has a lot of notes in it. So I liked this part about the blueprint. It says that there's three sections to 1 John, that God is light, God is love, and God is life. So today I read the third section, which is actually the fifth chapter of the book of 1 John, and that is that God is life. But the last couple days I've been studying the fourth chapter, which is God is love. And I thought I'd read something there and maybe talk about it a little. Not that I know what I'm going to say. I really don't have this planned out at all. I just know that I'm going to talk about love, and it's going to be less controversial than last week. Because after all, love is always nicer to think about than sin. So it says, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. In this, the love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us, and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another." I just love that. So I was looking in the notes. I always read the notes. And actually, when I study a book, I first read it in this Bible, reading all the notes along with it. And then I go to my other Bible, which is New American Standard, the inductive study Bible, and then I follow all the instructions that Kay Arthur gives on studying and writing in your Bible and things like that. So I don't know what good that does for me, except it does have me reading the book over and over and over. So I really feel like I have a better understanding of what is in there by the time I get done. But anyhow, I read this part first. And there was a note there where it says, God is love. And I thought that was very interesting. God is love. That's verse 8 in chapter 4. And the note says, John says God is love, not love is God. Our world, with its shallow and selfish view of love, has turned these words around and contaminated our understanding of love. The world thinks that love is what makes a person feel good, and that it is all right to sacrifice moral principles and others' rights in order to obtain such love. But that isn't real love. It is the exact opposite. selfishness, and God is not that kind of love. Real love is like God, who is holy, just, and perfect. If we truly know God, we will love as he does. So, you know, I had to think about that for a while, because I was born in the hippie generation. Let's just get right down to the facts right there. I'll tell you a little story. So I was about 15 years old when 1967 hit San Francisco, which was really close to where I lived. Where I lived, it was in the East Bay Area. I was in the little town of El Sobrante. Have you heard of it? So being out there, I was reading the San Francisco Chronicle stories about the hippies and how they loved each other, and I thought that was beautiful, that love was so important. But if only the rest of the scene had gone along with the idea that love is important. And it really didn't, because believe me, I was a teenager in the 60s in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I explored that scene, and I did not find love. And I went through my whole life looking for love. And I think I looked in all the wrong places, because I never really found the love that I was looking for until 2013, when I decided to give my life to Christ. And then I really felt loved. And he healed me. He healed my emotions. He healed my broken heart. And I have felt love ever since, thanks to Jesus. So, I liked the line in there that says, in this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins. So, because he loved us, we should love one another. And I think that's a beautiful message to ponder this week. So, I'm going to continue to read 1 John and maybe get back into this book, Abide in Christ, which I haven't been reading the last few weeks. I wish I was. But I haven't been because I've been feeling kind of rushed and needing to get things done quickly in the morning. So hopefully I can overcome that. I have a week ahead where I'm going to be doing a lot of work, but I still am going to make time for reading the Bible and for God in the morning. Because without that, the day just doesn't go well. So that is all I have to say for today. Hopefully this will not be as controversial as last week, and that everybody will end up loving one another, because it's a good thing. Talk to you in another video. Bye.